Vitamin C, I must say, it's one of my all-time favorites for many, many reasons I'm going to talk about today. This is going to be a complete tutorial on it. Should you be on it? What should you look for in a product? How should you use it? What are the results you might expect if you're using the right one in the right manner? Vitamin C is one of the most studied skincare ingredients. Topical vitamin C is what we're talking about, and it is a science-backed favorite ingredient that helps do what? Slows the early signs of skin aging. It prevents sun damage, and this is one of the key reasons I like it. I use it a lot if I'm out in the sun or on the water. It improves the appearance of wrinkles, dark spots, and acne. Now, those are the top three most common reasons that people are on this channel: wrinkles, dark spots, and acne. So it helps all of those. Not many people hear about acne all the time, but certainly it can help play a role in improving that. Vitamin C is an antioxidant, meaning it fights harmful free radicals and toxins that come in contact with your skin from external sources, like something I often talk about, air pollution. Inside the car, we get a lot of air pollution. Many people are inside the car in traffic, or they live in cities where our skin is inundated with pollutants from inside the body as well as outside, because within the body, there are processes within the metabolism that produces free radicals, and these can damage the skin. So applying vitamin C topically can combat these free radicals, and it's actually studied to improve the skin's overall appearance. Many clinical studies have demonstrated that vitamin C can improve wrinkles. In fact, one study showed daily use of vitamin C formulation for at least 3 months improved the appearance of fine and coarse wrinkles of the face and the neck. So it's often used on the neck, as well as improved overall skin texture and appearance. Notice in the studies, we're looking at 3 months, not 3 days or 3 weeks. But that's how long it takes for most skincare for you to really evaluate it. 3 months is a good rule of thumb for just about everything we're on. Now, there's immediate effects. Mine, for instance, is not much of a serum as it is more of a cream. And sometimes those kind of products are going to have hyaluronic acid, emollients, things that are going to make it look instantly better. But the actual vitamin C component to see results, give it some time, just like every other product, patience. Vitamin C may also help protect the skin from harmful ultraviolet rays, and of course, can be used in combination, which I recommend, with a broad spectrum sunscreen. This is, I think, one of the most fascinating parts of vitamin C, is its prevention, the role in maybe preventing, but also reversing sun damage. And prevention, I think, is key, because a lot of times you're out in the sun, you know, you feel a little tight. You feel like I got too much sun that day, even though you may have had a wide brim hat, sunglasses, you may have had your SPF. There is something you can do after the fact. Clinical studies have shown that combining vitamin C with other topical ingredients, namely ferulic and vitamin E, can diminish redness and help protect the skin from long-term damage caused by the sun's harmful rays. And the sun is getting stronger and stronger, and skin cancer more prevalent. In addition, vitamin C can reduce the appearance of dark spots by blocking the production of pigment in our skin. In clinical trials, the majority of the participants applying topical vitamin C had an improvement in their dark spots with very little irritation or side effects. But more studies are definitely needed to confirm this effect of vitamin C. We certainly see it in clinical practice because we see a brightening effect. Oftentimes people come in for dark spots, they might not want IPLs, they might not want lasers, maybe they tried them, or concomitantly you can use these products to brighten the skin along with the lasers, the fractionated treatment, CO2 laser, because they do in fact help healing. But sunspots, I must say, just about everyone walking in, no matter what they're coming in for, Botox, fillers, they will mention, hey, what about this spot or that spot? So vitamin C is part of a daily routine, can be key. Vitamin C, now acne, a lot of people don't associate with helping with acne, but it is anti-inflammatory. And those properties that help control the sebum or the oil production within the skin also help with acne. In clinical trials, twice daily application of vitamin C reduced acne lesions when compared to placebo. So they gave these people topical vitamin C, some people placebos, meaning something that didn't have any active effect, and then compared the two groups. Again, no serious side effects were reported within the vitamin C use in any of these studies. It's important to note that there are only a handful of clinical studies that have studied the effects for vitamin C, and studies need to be confirmed for acne, but it is an interesting kind of side effect that people see, less acne. Now, the formulation you use will be important because there may be acne form products within their vitamin C serum. People pack all kinds of different things in vitamin C. And some people will like a more cream. Like, I like that because then it's the only thing I might need in the morning. I don't need a moisturizer on top of it. And that's why I have my vitamin C more of a lotion serum than a full serum that wouldn't provide that moisture. I think keeping skincare simple is a key because not using skincare is the biggest problem. And if the skincare is too complicated, people don't use it. You just saw from this that there wasn't a lot of irritation or side effects with vitamin C. That's why a lot of people are on it. Unlike a retinol or retinoic, they get irritation and they come off of it. So compliance is an issue, and I think that's what makes vitamin C so effective. People actually use it. They comply because there aren't a lot of side effects. Where to find topical vitamin C and what to look for on the label? Well, vitamin C can be found both in serums and creams, as I mentioned. Different formulations of vitamin C can alter its strength and effects in the skin. So what else is put in there with the vitamin C plays a big role. And formulations do play a role because of, if nothing else, absorption and stability. Vitamin C isn't the most stable compound. You want to purchase a vitamin C product that's relatively fresh, preferably with active L-ascorbic acid, because that is the most studied, albeit not the most stable. A strength of 10 to 20% is very common. Now, some people do get some irritation from vitamin C. Mine is 20%. Most people that come to me or on skincare want results. They want power. And it's much easier to dilute it on your own than to make it stronger. Meaning, you can make products stronger by applying them as your first layer. But in general, if something's a little too strong for you, it's easy to dilute it down with a neutral than to try and get more effect out of a 10% per se. I'd rather you try and take that 20% because oftentimes people can build up to it. So dilute it down a little bit and then work up to using the full concentration. You're also looking for something with a low pH. This combination has been studied in the clinical trial. So a lower pH product, and you see how complex this all is. The formula you use does in fact make a difference. Now, how do you use topical vitamin C? During your morning routine of skincare is often a great way to use it. And if it is moisturizing, you can apply your serum, say hyaluronic acid serum, or your growth factors, like I use Antiage growth factors. You can apply your vitamin C after that. If it's moisturizing, it might be your last step. Of course, the very last step is always going to be sunscreen if you're going out or being exposed to the UVA or B rays. So it can be used in the morning. It can also be used in the evening, of course. Sun sensitivity, I've never found to be a big problem with vitamin C. So in general, use a gentle cleanser. Remove pollutants. You always want to start with a clean slate. If you're using a pure vitamin C, you apply a few drops of the vitamin C serum to the face and neck. It can be used on the neck and, of course, the under eyes. And then you can apply your moisturizer and sunscreen. You may experience a mild tingling sensation with the use of vitamin C, but many people don't. You may then choose to begin applying it every other day at first, especially if you're on one like mine that's a 20%, it might be a little much, and then work your way up to using it as much as every day. May take up to 3 months of consistent use, of course, as we mentioned, to see a noticeable improvement and to get yourself up to the full 20% daily. If you experience substantial discomfort or irritation, you just stop using it and or you can dilute it as mentioned. If you're using as part of a nighttime routine, you cleanse the skin. I like something with a lipid type of cleanser, something that's moisturizing, especially in the evening. If you are using vitamin C for acne, then a salicylic cleanser would be great. But if you don't have the acne problem, cleanse the skin. Vitamin C can be your only step for the evening. But for a lot of people, that's when they're going to put their retinols or their anti-age type of growth factors on. And you want to have that as your first step and your vitamin C as your last if it's moisturizing like mine. If you have a pure light serum, you then may put the serum on first and then you put on your retinol or your anti-age type of growth factors. One caveat here would be if you're on retinols and you get just a slight amount of irritation and you're on the evening that you're going to use your retinol, but you don't want it as strong as it is pure. And this goes for retinol or retinoic acid. Cleanse the skin, put on your vitamin C, and your retinol goes on top of that. So as your retinol is your last step, it will be less active. The more active you want your retinol, more towards your first step after cleansing. And you can even leave a little moisture on the skin if you really want a strong retinol. But I don't want inflammaging, meaning I don't want inflammation on your skin ever, unless it's if it's as part of a chemical peel or a procedure. That's short-term inflammation. We don't want chronic inflammation. Vitamin C can be very soothing and doesn't often give a lot of inflammation. Let's go now. Let's look at the ingredients in my product. There are many products out there, but this will give you an idea of some ingredients. Okay, so if we come to my site here, we scroll down, let's go to the beauty store, and let's see what we have. We go to best sellers, I'm sure it's under there. Here you go. So there's vitamin C, and let's go down and let's look at ingredients. Okay, here we are. Okay, so if we look at the ingredients here, we have organic aloe leaf juice is the first one. There's a lot of oils. It's more of a lotion than a pure serum because I want people to be able to use it without having to put extra moisturizer on, especially those who are even a little bit dry. If you're super dry, you might then need to put the ultra moisture on after. But there's rosehip seed oil. You see here, we got vitamin C ester. The ester is going to be a little more stable version than L-ascorbic acid with vitamin E. That's a great combination. Those two work synergistically together. And then you see a lot of fruit extracts, red raspberry fruit, organic blueberry fruit, organic white willow bark extract, organic neem seed oil, organic rosemary leaf extract, organic sunflower seed oil. So you see a lot of organics in there. And the idea again is that it's going to moisturize, it works synergistically, it's available, and that 20% is going to get to where it needs, and you don't have to use a lot of other steps with it. So vitamin C, very, very important product. What one do you want, like, which do you love? Do you not like vitamin C's? I put a complete playlist up here for things you can do at home, keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.